filled with dust. We kissed in the fields and under trees, screaming like dogs, bleeding dark and
Well, I am indeed tired. Being busy cleaning up all day, let me tell you, it's a big house to clean. I had to help the hired help today, seeing as the scale of what had to be cleaned was quite magnificent. Thing is, what I was cleaning up was what some would call unsavoury substances. Blood. Blood is that substance. Whose blood? What blood? Who knows? Well, in all honesty, I do know. I just like to build tension ever so slightly. I enjoy tension, see? I enjoy suspense. I enjoy anxiety. I enjoy the rush one gets from it. The rush one gets from inflicting these feelings upon one's victims. Well, of course, you don't know what I actually do for a living, do you? Well, I own this splendid country manor house here in Staffordshire, and I invite the loving members of the public to stay for weekends and events, you know. However, when these people enter my lair, they don't quite know what fate awaits them, what horrid creatures they may encounter here. Well, that's just one of the most appealing things to us. Yes, us. Me, my only other equal, the one who shares my blood, my passion, my sadistic nature. My brother. My dear brother and I have only each other. We certainly had a coloured past, a scarred childhood, some would call it, but to us, it's a childhood we were always going to have to fulfil our destiny, no matter how bloody, hellish and evil that destiny is. It's ours, and we're reveling in it. Of course, the guests rarely see my cold blood brother around the manor in general. I mean, he's no way near as articulate and charming as I. However, we both excel in the particularly tough subject areas, such as blood, gore, death, and much more. I do think that we should have actually gained some degrees for them, rather than apply degree burns to our much admired guests. And then we have the girls that are the most enjoyable to stalk, to torture, to murder. Just hearing those screams of fear, terror, exhaustion, the torture just being too much for them to bear.
Please don't kill me! Please!
We thrive on these moments. And the boys, the ones who think that they're better than they are. They are the ones who think that they're tough, think that they behold no fear. However, when they get pushed to the limit, when push comes to shove, when they come throat to blade, steel to skull, they're not as tough as they like to pretend. They're just like any other mortal. They're vulnerable, scared, weak, pathetic. Poor, unassuming creatures. They're walking with the reapers, and they're about to enter the serpent's lair. Sick? Sadistic? manacle? No. No, not quite. We prefer to call it the subtle art of murder.